Let's take a look at creating this feature. At first glance, it seems like a simple lofted cut should do the trick. But this is complicated by the fact that this face is at an angle. Also, we want to be able to control both these profiles with sketches at the top. I've created both sketches beforehand on the top face of the cuboid. The outer sketch defines the outer region, while the inner sketch defines the inner region. We need to define a side profile of this slope. To do that, I've sketched a line here on the front face. You can directly use the outer sketch as a first loft profile. For the second loft profile, we need to project the inner sketch onto the slope. Let's extrude this line into a surface body. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Extrude. Select the sketch line as a profile. I'm going to extrude this into an arbitrary distance. Let's hide the solid body for now. And also hide the outer sketch. To perform a project to surface, we can actually create a sketch on any plane. For the sake of convenience, let's begin a sketch on this face. Go to Create. Project include, project to surface. Select this face. For curves, click on the select box. Double click on any of the sketch segments to select the whole chain. By default, this is projected at the closest point. But this is not what we need. We need a projection straight down. If we bring back the solid body, we can see that this segment of the inner sketch actually aligns with the edge of the cuboid. If we project straight down, the projected line should be where the surface body cuts into the right face of the solid body. Change the project type to a long vector. And select the y-axis. This will change it to a straight down projection. Finish the sketch. Hide the surface body and the original inner sketch. Let's rename the projected sketch. Bring back the outer sketch. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Create, Loft. Select the outer sketch as a first profile. Hover over the second profile. Press and hold the left mouse button until you see a drop-down menu. Select the projected inner sketch as the second profile. If you find that the lofted surface is not flat enough, you can add in rails. Let's roll back the timeline to before the loft. Bring back the outer and projected inner sketches. let's hide the solid body for now. We are going to perform a 3D sketch. This can be done on any plane. Check on the 3D sketch option in the sketch palette. We can draw straight lines between the endpoints of the arcs. You know that you have snapped onto a point when you see a square. Bring back the solid body. Roll forward the timeline. Go into the loft feature. Click on the select box for rails and select the newly created sketch lines. There is actually another way of projecting the inner sketch without actually having to create a surface body. Let's roll the timeline to before the surface body was created. Bring back the inner and slope sketches. Create a sketch on any plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersection Curve. Select the slope line as a curve. For curves or faces, double-click on the inner sketch. This produces the same projection as a Project to Surface command without actually a need for a surface body.